evening. Thank you all for being here, first of all. We're very excited to start off the Faculty Artist Series this year. And you know, typically we just come out and start playing, which is also beautiful, but we felt like it would be nice to kind of open this up with just a little bit of discussion about these pieces. In lieu of program notes, we thought we would tell you a little bit in person. So again, first of all, thank you for being here, all of you students, friends. Thank you to my mother and sister. Thank you to our dean for supporting these artistic activities and being here with us. So on the first half of this program, we're going to hear a piece by Joseph Haydn, who's an Austrian composer, 18th century. And Haydn is known for many things. Among them, he's known for being the father of the string quartet. Clearly not what you're going to hear tonight. So before Haydn became a prolific composer of quartets, he wrote a number of trios for an instrument called the baryton, B-A-R-Y-T-O-N. And the baryton was more like a viol than like the modern instruments that you see here. It had 6 or 7 bowed strings, as well as a number of sympathetic strings, which could be plucked, but mostly would just resonate with the other strings. So a very unusual instrument, very popular at that time, fell out of use in the 1800s. So when Haydn was employed by Prince Esterhazy, the prince was a fan of this instrument, the baryton, and it was because of this that Haydn wrote 126 of these trios. So now they have been, many of them have been rewritten for violin instead of baryton, and viola and cello. After the Haydn, we'll hear a piece by a Mexican composer named Mario Lavista. Mario Lavista, 20th century and 21st. This piece that you'll hear tonight was written in 2001. It may not have been performed in the United States before, we're not sure. It has not been recorded, so without a doubt you haven't heard this. And it is indeed unlike anything you've heard before. It is quite short and quite energetic. 3 movements. The first is Invention for 2 Voices. And again, there are 3 of us. This is an interesting idea where there is a pair of people playing the melody at any time, and the third person, an invention. 2 people playing an invention and the third person accompanying. 2nd movement of the Lavista is music box, caja de música. And I think you'll hear once, because you know that you're expecting to hear music box, I think you'll see what he did with some extended techniques and strange sounds that will bring that kind of music box flavor to life. And the 3rd movement, dance. Very energetic and exciting, not quite something that I think any of us would successfully dance to, but you'll understand without a doubt the flavor of the dance. So, Haydn and Lavista.
Thank you. Thank you. want to thank you so much for coming and joining us for this great music. It has been a really fun journey to work on it and prepare it so quickly at the beginning of the semester. But we don't regret it. And I guess I'll make a little announcement. One reason we put the Dohnányi on this program is because we have received a grant in conjunction with the Wichita Ballet. And they had, the grant suggested there was a vision for a chamber music group to be performing live on stage while an original choreographed work was danced. And so, anyway, we decided on Dohnányi. That will be in April, and it'll be down at the Orpheum Theater with multiple performances, and I believe that we're also have been asked by the Kansas City Ballet to perform it there. So we need to be pretty good at it. The one thing I would just like to say is that, you know, we communicate a lot about our rehearsals and what we're going to play via text message, and I've kind of gotten to be a fan of, you know, just talking to Siri. It's clear to me that Siri has not a clue who Dohnányi is, because I've gotten really interesting translations, D-O-C-K, capital Y-A-N-N-I. Then there was Dr. Ani. and then there was Duck, D-U-C-K, Yanni. Anyway, it was a little amusing. Dohnányi was really, I think he's probably one of my favorite kind of relatively unknown composers. He was Hungarian. At the turn of the century, the 19th century, he was about 23. And he wrote this piece when he was 25, which kind of blows my mind because it has become truly beloved. He was a pianist, a very famous pianist, and a very famous conductor as well, obviously a composer. He did write other chamber works, a couple of piano quintets and a couple of string quartets. He, one thing I thought was really interesting, he, at the time of the Second World War, was the conductor for the Budapest Philharmonic, and he had been instructed by the Nazis to get rid of anyone in the orchestra that had questionable heritage or religious beliefs. He refused to do that, and instead, he dissolved the entire orchestra so that no one would suffer. This piece is a serenade. Serenades often have some shorter movements and more movements. We start out with a march. Second movement is a romanza. And the third movement is a scherzo that I kind of like to think of as choreographed by a troop of chimpanzees on steroids. the fourth movement is a beautiful theme and variations, and it's very tragic. And the last movement is just a good old barn dance. So we hope that you enjoy this piece.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.